What is up, visualizers? STV in Motion here again, and today I want to do some mind sharing with you. I want to show you some cool stuff I prepared here in this composition, mainly this creature, how I created it, also why are different parts of it beaming on the rhythm, and all kinds of colorizing that you can make for it. Let's first see a full screen of this. This is one option. Here's another one. This is happening with bloom. Let's see another option maybe. Yeah, check this out. I call it the fire beast. Another look. We can also add our favorite edge detection thingy and get a look like this. We can of course change the colors, maybe give it a more of a purple haze look. And what else? Maybe we can also give it... See, there are so many possibilities here, and that's why it's not a tutorial, it's more an overview of what can be done, because it took me a couple of hours to get to all these looks. So let's turn off all of these colorizing effects and let's check it out. The main look is black and white. It's part of the Ornamental 2 pack that myself and Nadia created. The pulsing thing are levels on each one of the layers. Let me close the levers for a minute and let me show you how I made it. So let's take for instance this clip. This is actually made from this clip, and what I did is I said I want to take this clip and I want to, let's add a transform on it, and let's add a mirror on it, and let's rotate it. So it all started like this, and then I said okay, two eyes, let's put something in the back, this thing. And the way I did this was to take this kind of thing, also add a transform on it. And these are these things, you see, you cannot play it as is at the show. It's a building block for you, and that's why I built it to be modular, so you can build your own stuff. So this is this part and this part together. Now, if we look closer, you see that these parts are not interacting. One is not casting any shadow on the other one, or having this kind of ambient occlusion. So what I like to do in these cases is add a drop shadow. And I got a preset made. Let's put it before everything. And then dropping two of them to make it very pronounced. So now you see that one is making a little bit of ambient occlusion on the other. Fake ambient occlusion. So that's how I did this, and then I got this part, just getting it to its location, to its place. So I'm going to scale it down, I'm going to push it some more, and now we've got this thingy here. Maybe we can get the eyes. Let's Control Shift T to get the thumbnail updated. Let's maybe push them a little bit upwards. No sideways, like this, you see. That's nice. And the last part was me taking these, trying to make these horns or something. So I got this. And then I wanted to, of course, scale it down, because this size is just the maximum size for you to be able to to replicate it. You get as many pixels as possible. So let's rotate it, but I don't want it to rotate on this axis. I want it to rotate on somewhere around here. So what I need to do is to change the anchor point to about something like this. You see now it rotates on a different axis. And maybe I want to take it little bit upwards. Yeah. So what you see now is that way, if I take a mirror here, we got these horns, but they're too big right now. We can scale them down, we can get them closer. Now I'd like to animate them. So I see that the 120, 115 and up to 135, that's about right. I'm going to get the rotation, add a BPM sync, and then we said 100 and something and 135. So I think it was 15. That's great. Let's add an envelope here and let it bounce slower. And now let's see all of them together. Here we can fix here that it won't be that it won't get that. No, the other side. Alrighty, so we got this creature here. Let's close everything and let me show you how I got to this to the pulsing of light. Let's do it on the clip itself. So first I try to play, I play a little bit with the colorize, and I use this preset. It's this one here, Vididis. I did this and then I wanted to, you know, a little bit make it more polynot. So what I did is I like to take levels, and I had a whole tutorial made on colorizing. So I really recommend that you will see it. See what's going on here, because I'm playing with the ratio here, I can change the colors. I think I had bloom as well on. So, and bloom is a relatively new effect in Resolum, and it just takes the highlights and crushes them. So you see, so I said, okay, that's nice. Let's pulsate it like this, from 56 to 66, say. So we're going to take it on the BPM sync and pulsate it from the 56, I guess, to 66. Something about this, and let's add an envelope. And this envelope I used for to the floor. Check it out. So it's already pulsating, and that's really nice. I can of course pulsate it slower and faster. And that's about it for the pulsating, but let's close here, this one here. We don't need it. And let's activate this and open. Now the pulsating, I moved it later to the layer, because if I do it like this, I'll have anything that I will put on the layers, place on the layers, of course, will pulsate according to this envelope here. So what I did, I added a different, you see this level has a four to the floor. And this one has the same for the floor, but this one has 4 beats and this one has 8 beats. So this one is pulsating really fast, and this one pulsate in half the pulsation. And what I did here, let's activate it. Let's turn off this one so you can see. So this one is pulsating on the offbeat. What I did is I took the four to the floor points. It was in, the beat was in 0, then it was in 25, 50, etc. So I moved the points. This is in 12.5, this is in 35.7, etc. So this is pulsating on the offbeat. I really even did this preset for it, so I can activate it really fast. And we have here another one on the end. It's a different preset, I think it's this one. So, and you see, all of them are pulsating in different times, and when this covers them all, we got this really cool look. Then the fun thing that if I'll add anything in the different layers, they will all pulsate together. I made this background to pulsate really slow, only once in a couple of bits, because I don't want to overload with too much lights. Speaking of, let's get into the dark mode, and maybe I'll show you a couple of examples of how it everything is pulsating because we have different layers here. And of course, we can add more glow if we'd like to, and change the different views, different colorizations. Let's talk about colorizations now. So let's turn these off. So you know that this was this preset, and I played with a couple of different presets. I added this, I added then a U-rotate for to get a different color and levels, and that's how I got the red. The red thingy with the bloom, it goes well. We can also take the edge detection, maybe that's nice. This out how it's all pulsating, boom, boom. It's nice. And what do we have here? We have edge detection, just the basic, the default. We added this colorization, the bloom is here. You know, I can just create so many variations here with adding and subtracting effects here. Alrighty, these visuals that I was playing today are part of the Ornamental 2 pack. Music was Yuve, Smashing One. If you like to learn VGAing and Resolume techniques, I got a playlist with some of the best tutorials on this channel for you to take a look at. I'll see you on the next one.